Hello friends, welcome to this video on Heron's formula. In the previous video, we discussed about Heron's formula and solved some questions. Today, we will discuss the application of Heron's formula in finding the areas of quadrilaterals. So let's start. Friends, using Heron's formula, we can find the area of any triangle when we know the length of all its three sides. But can we use it to find the area of other polygons? Can these polygons be divided into triangles? Yes. If we draw a diagonal in a quadrilateral, then we will get two triangles. Now, by using Heron's formula in both of them, we can find their area. And adding them up, we can find the area of this quadrilateral. Similarly, we can divide this pentagon into three triangles and this hexagon into four triangles. And if we know the length of the diagonal and the sides of all these figures, then using Heron's formula, we can easily find the area of all these figures. In this session, we will apply Heron's formula to find only the areas of quadrilaterals. Now let's take one question. Friends, in a parallelogram ABCD, diagonal BD equals 18 cm and the perimeter of ABCD is given to be 60 cm. It's also given that AB is 2 times BC and we have to find the area of parallelogram ABCD. Friends, can you tell how we should start? Here, we need to know the length of all the sides. So, first of all, we will find the length of all the sides of this parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram, that is AB will be equal to CD and BC will be equal to DA. Let's call it equation 1. We are also given the perimeter of the parallelogram, that is AB plus BC plus CD plus DA equals 60 cm. Let's call it equation 2. Using equation 1, we can write equation 2 as follows. We will get AB plus BC equal to 30. We are given that AB is equal to 2BC. In equation 3, in place of AB, we can write 2BC. On doing so, we get the length of BC as 10 cm. Since AB is equal to 2BC, AB will be equal to 20 cm. Since AB is equal to CD, the measure of CD will also be 20 cm. And BC is equal to DA, hence DA will also be 10 cm. Now, we will find the area of this parallelogram. Since we are not given any information about its height, we cannot use the formula base multiplied by height. But we know that the diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. This means their areas will be equal. If we get the area of any one of these triangles, then we can double it to find the area of the parallelogram. So let's find the area of triangle ABD using Heron's formula. Heron's formula is square root of S multiplied by S minus A multiplied by S minus B multiplied by S minus C. We will substitute the value of A equal to 20 cm, B equal to 18 cm and C equal to 10 cm. Now we will find the semi-perimeter, that is S. Here, we got semi-perimeter as 24 cm. Now, we will find the value of S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. We can write the area of triangle ABD in this way and substitute it in the formula. Here, instead of finding the product of these numbers, we will find their factors. In this way, the area of triangle ABD will be 24 root 14 square centimeters. And now we can substitute its value in this equation 7 to find the area of the parallelogram. We get the area of the parallelogram ABCD as 48 root 14 square centimeters. Friends, that's all in this session. Today, we learned to find the areas of quadrilateral by applying Heron's formula. In the next session, we will solve some more interesting questions related to this. So see you in the next video. Thank you.